Besides the oceans, the grasslands of the Earth are the second largest carbon sink on the planet. So when I look at cattle, they are the managers of that land who are going to help us not just preserve it, but actually intensify the sequestration process of those grasslands.
We operate what would be the largest seed stock production business in the United States. We own about 4,000 bulls and then about another 1,000 breeding females. We do on our operations rotational grazing. And the goal there is to get the cattle out, graze on the grass. It's kind of like mowing your yard. You graze on the grass, you hit it once, and then you leave it alone. You're there for a day or two, then the grass has time to rest and regrow, and you're not sacrificing the root under the soil. You have healthier soils, you have better plant diversity, and you're creating a sustainable system.
Vence is short for virtual fencing, and we're building a platform that actually enables the sustainable management of livestock. Our solution starts off with a collar that goes on cattle and enables us to remove the need for physical fencing on livestock farms and allows customers to dynamically move animals from place to place and control animals on their farms without the need for that physical infrastructure. We utilize a combination of GPS, low power wide area communications networks, and then on animal machine learnings to actually communicate to that device what that animal should be doing. And then we process all that up in the cloud where we're utilizing large pools of data to enhance what we're able to do on each animal.
It's hard to rotationally graze 1,000 cows. That's teams of people that basically would be dedicated to constantly moving these animals around. And you're building, you know, temporary fence every day and moving in. It's just a lot of work. Well, you put a GPS collar on a cow where maybe, you know, she was in a large pasture before. We can take that collar and divide that large pasture up into three or four smaller ones. The animal is healthier because they're out doing what they're supposed to be doing. There's a strong financial benefit for us. It's also better for the soil. In 2019, we grazed about 1,500 acres of farmland. On that 1,500 acres of farm ground that we grazed, we built, on average, about 1% of organic matter more than the farm ground where we didn't graze. When we build 1% of organic matter, that is 12,000 pounds of carbon that we have sequestered into an acre of soil, simply from grazing cattle out on that farm ground acre. So that would be 9,000 tons of carbon that we pulled out of the atmosphere and we sequestered into our soils. A lot of groups will try and blame cattle for climate change. And that, in my opinion, is a perfect example of how that's untrue.
Rabobank, they're the world's largest commercial agricultural bank. And they have a program called Food Bites, which is an accelerator that you can go through, and it helps technology companies in the food and agricultural space ramp up their products and get their product to market. After participating in that, we were able to bring on Rabobank as one of our investors. And so every conversation that we have with them as an organization is not just about today. They are talking about 10 years from now, 20 years from now, how they're helping and how they think we should help shape the future of food and the future of agriculture.
We own that land, we lease that land, but it's not ours forever, right? I have four sons. It's my responsibility to make sure that the land is in just as good a shape for them or better than it was for me.